Okay, hi, Bill Harrison here with A Lesson on Demand. And I just played Fly Me to the Moon in the key of B-flat, all in thumb position. And the reason I did that was because today we're going to talk about thumb position. By request. I had a teacher years ago who said that a good way to think of thumb position is as if the thumb is going to replace the nut. So when we start out working, we're going to be placing the thumb at the octave node, okay? So your thumb is going to take the place of what would be the open string, okay, just from a mental point of view. And the other thing he said was, imagine that third finger, ring finger, is going to do the things that fourth finger does when you're down in the lower part of the bass. Okay, so we're going to replace fourth finger with third finger. I think thumb position is actually easier in a lot of ways than playing in regular position. And here's the reason why. A couple reasons. First of all, you've got everything right in front of you, as opposed to when you're playing in the money positions, everything's kind of here. It's hard to see if you need to see. In thumb position, everything is right in your line of sight. All you have to do is just look down a little bit. Everything's right there. Okay, number two. When you're playing in this part of the bass, there's a very common tendency to squeeze with your thumb. And a lot of the problems that bass players have is in the musculature here, because we have a tendency to squeeze too much, of course people play like this too, they grab onto it. Ideally, you don't do that. Ideally, you're using the weight of your arm against your body to pull the string down to the fingerboard. That's the ideal way. A lot of people don't really play that way. Everybody uses a certain amount of thumb, I would say. I don't think I've ever seen a bass player who looked to me like they weren't using any pressure or weight on their thumb. Anyway, in thumb position, you don't have that issue because the entire weight of this apparatus here, from the shoulder on down, goes right into the string directly. You don't have any thumb behind it pulling or anything like that. So you've got the whole machine here to help you to push the string down. Okay, that's the second thing. The third thing is pretty obvious. When you're in half position, those notes are pretty far apart. In thumb position, the half steps, look how small those are by comparison. Everybody's seen this, right? Right? So where the chin follows the hand, right? I don't really think that's a very good idea. First of all, it's bad for your back, and certainly it doesn't really do anything to help your playing, in my opinion. It's much easier to bass come to you, right? So when I go into thumb position, I just bring the bass a little closer into my body rather than having it out here. So I don't have to do this to reach. I just bring the bass back so that my left hand can reach as high up as I want it to go. Okay, so instead of this, right, we've got just let the bass come back to you, okay? That's controversial, just so you know. First thing we have to do is find the harmonic node with the thumb. And to start off with, let's not close. Right, don't push the string down with your thumb just yet. We'll get to that. What you're going to have to do is you're going to have to wind up getting first very sore and then developing a callus on the bone, if I can quite show that, but on this part of the bone, much the same place where if you play electric bass and you use your thumb, it's sort of the same kind of spot. It's right on the crease, it's where the bones connect, somewhere in there. And that's going to have to toughen up with time. But for our purposes right now, I suggest that you just find the node with your thumb and kind of practice going across so that you can kind of not fall off the node as you, you know, not go this way or that way. It's just kind of, it's sort of the same thing as when you're learning how to play in position, where you don't want to be turning the hand any funny way. You want to make sure to go straight across as much as you can, as if you were making a fret with the thumb. To start off with, what we want to do is put a half step between each finger. So I've got the G on the node, I've got a G sharp with my first finger, an A natural, which I'm checking against the harmonic node on the A string. I want to make sure it's in tune. And then a B flat or A sharp. Just like you would play down on the lower part of the bass, right? It would be open. You can't see this, but so it would be open, first finger, second finger, fourth finger, G sharp, A, B flat, or A sharp, right? Okay, so that's the first position that you can start getting a feel for. And yes, of course, you can do it on the other strings. It all depends on how much stamina you have. Right? You might want to just stay on the G and the D string for a little while, just till you get a little strength and you get a little bit of callus and you start to get the feeling for, you know, how this is in front of you instead of behind the bass like you're used to having it. All right. You have to use your own good judgment on that. All right. The second position here is where we put a whole step. It's as if we're going to play in first position down in the lower part of the bass. You put a whole step. So we're going from the G to the A natural with first finger, then a B flat, then a B natural. So I can play, could play the beginning of a scale in major or minor. Right? Okay, now you see that I am closing the note. It's actually, in the long run, it will be easier, but you have to get yourself a callus here first. Okay, so the third position here is where we put keep the first finger on the A natural, and now we're going to put a whole step between 1 and 2, A, B, and then a half step. So we have the top half of a C major scale. Let's leave it at that in terms of the positions, right? So you've got this half position, this first position, and for lack of a better term, we'll call this third position. Okay, only one other thing I want to show you today, which will allow you to play the tune that I played on the way in. What was that again? Oh yeah, Fly Me to the Moon. In B flat, because it's all B flat major scale. I played it all in this kind of closed position, except for the one spot where I had to play an F sharp, right? So it's all. Right? Except for the one place where it goes. Where it goes to. A harmonic minor on G. There's a D, E flat, F sharp, and then to the G. Okay, so that's really the only spot where you have something that's outside of the key of B flat. And then you have to shift up to a D, but I'm gonna leave that part out for the time being. So that's a little introduction on the thumb position. It's going to take a little time to get used to everything about this. It's just it's going to feel awkward and strange until you do it for a little while. The location of the notes, and also I think the most difficult physical part is just going to be getting your thumb, you know, to stop hurting. No other nice way to put it. It will hurt for a while because you're trying to use a part of your body that you haven't used at all before for these kinds of, you know, it's a very fine motor skill here. So you're gonna have some soreness, and eventually you'll get a callus, just like when you started playing and didn't have calluses on your other fingers. So I hope this helps you. We'll talk about thumb position again in a little while, but I hope this helps at least get you started with it. Happy thumbing.